Hello everyone, I welcome you all on the 11th lecture of Microprocessor and Computer Architecture. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the instructions and we have seen the same concept of programming by performing, or I can say writing the particular code as an example. Okay, and we have practiced on it as well. So in this session, we will focus on interrupts which are available in the 8086. So this lecture basically covers the concept of interrupt in detail. So I will begin the session with discussing the type of interrupts, then we'll focus on a software interrupt and hardware interrupt. Then I will discuss the concept of interrupt vector table, what it is and what is the significance of interrupt vector table. And later on, I will focus on how to calculate the memory, required memory to store the interrupt vector table, because all the processor and controller having a fixed interrupt service addresses, which we are calling sometimes as an interrupt service routine addresses as well. So those addresses are fixed, and those addresses will be stored in the one table, which is known as the interrupt vector table. So for that, how much memory required? So that calculation will be discussed, how to carry out it, an example will be taken. Then further, we'll discuss the software interrupts which are available in 8086, which help us while we execute the program. And later on, I will take the example for one hardware interrupt by taking one case study. So this is all will be part of this session. So thank you very much and have happy learning.